Welcome to this week's Dramatic Drama Weekend. Get your medications ready because this drama is bipolar. Gong, otherwise known as Princess Hours or Palace, is a major twist on a Cinderella story. It was made by the same writers who made Playful Kiss only before Playful Kiss, evidenced by the teddy bear ending in every episode. The story is based around an imaginary modern-day reality where there is still an active royal family in Korea. Now, I don't know about you guys, but if I was going to be imagining a world where I could marry the Prince of Korea, I would not make it so dramatic, and I would definitely make it less terrible. The description of this drama is romantic comedy, which is the only part of this that I laughed at, because there is nothing funny about this show, and it was very much not romantic. Plus, in the synopsis, the writers lied to us. Just give this bit a listen. Gong is a story about young love in the face of tradition, politics, and intrigue. Okay, first of all, the young couple hated each other. Any sign of love was at the very end of the drama where they finally admit it. And really, it took a long time for them to even get to the point where they even realized that they could possibly have feelings for each other other than hatred. In the story, they're forced to get married because the reigning king is sick and they need to prepare Shin, the crown prince, to become king. And Chaeyoung needs to get married to him because he can give money to her family who is in severe debt. The side stories in this drama were okay. Chaeyoung's friends, they were pretty funny and they lightened the mood a little bit because it was very dramatic. Had they not been there, I probably would have gone into a deep state of depression. Shin's friends, on the other hand, were big fat jerks, and I wanted to kill them the second I saw them. And then there comes Hyorin, who is the ex-girlfriend of Shin. I think the writers wanted me to feel bad for her, because she loved Shin and they couldn't be together, but she made that choice. She had her chance. He asked her to marry him. She said, no, I want to live out my dance career. And he told her straight up that if she didn't marry him, he would have to marry someone else. But for some reason, she looked hurt when she saw that he was actually getting married, that he wasn't waiting for her, even though he told her that he couldn't. And P.S. Giving up on your dream isn't going to change the fact that he got married. And still trying to be his girlfriend while he is married isn't going to make things better either. It's just going to put you in the bad light. Double P.S. Trying to kill yourself because you can't be with him isn't going to solve the problem either. Once again, you had your chance. Stop acting like the victim here. Gong's mother was actually a pretty good twist in the story. I actually did like her before she came to the palace, but the second that she stepped in it, somehow she became this evil, manipulating, plotting, crazy woman. Which could actually be the explanation for a lot of the characters' bipolar actions. Now that I think about it, all of the hatred and negative feelings happened within the palace, but when they would step out of it, for example, when Shin visits Chaekyung's family, he was actually really close to her and they were touching each other and playing and it was all really happy. The second they got back, they were complete strangers again and hated each other. There's something to do with that palace, I'm telling you. And then there's Shin's sister who popped out of nowhere with no reference to her even existing until she showed up. And then they all act like, oh yes, she's been here the entire time. Of course she's existed. She's Shin's oldest sister. Like I believe that for a second, writers. I give Chaeyoung a 2 on the doormat scale. I have to commend her on her willingness to sacrifice herself into a marriage with this jerk. However, she did let him push her around a little bit in the relationship when she started to realize that she liked him. So that's why she gets the 2. And she also kind of let Shin's friends push her around and let them embarrass her, even though she's the crown princess, which in my opinion, in those situations, she should have just put her crown on and told them to shove it. She did it to Shin enough times. Why didn't she do it to his friends? Interestingly enough, for the first time ever, I felt like her being a doormat would have helped her relationship. Sometimes Shin would actually go out of his way to do something kind, but she would kind of bite that in the butt and fight back because she's not a doormat. And when I say bite, she literally did bite him. Maybe if she would have relented in the beginning, they wouldn't have such a strained relationship and they might have been able to admit their lust for each other sooner. But once again, these characters are bipolar. So she would jump from, oh my gosh, I hate you. Oh, I need you. Oh, I'm gonna bite you. I think I like you. You're a jerk. I want to help you and love you. I want a divorce. Needless to say, these characters need some serious bipolar medication. I give the jerk face character in this drama a good 6 on a 10 on the jerk face scale. I seriously never thought I would find a worse jerk than Gu Jinpyo. But actually, I do believe that Shin is worse. At least Jinpyo cared about Johnny's feelings and tried to protect her at least a few times. Shin was never there for her. In fact, he ignored some of the situations that was inflicting his wife. He did show a little bit of emotion when she caught the infamous Korean drama 24-hour plague. He starts to understand her pain a little bit more about being living in the palace at this point, but he really doesn't do anything to help. He could have gone one step further and brought a humidifier into her room, because if I have learned anything from Korean dramas, the mere presence of a humidifier will cure a patient who is this close to death. This patient has gone into cardiac arrest. Quick, get the humidifiers! I'm sorry, Mr. Smith, but I don't know what's wrong with your daughter. But don't worry, I put a humidifier in her room, so we're pretty sure that she'll be okay in a couple hours. Okay? I understand that you have cancer, ma'am, so I'm going to prescribe to you the best medication I know. But I guess the lack of his caring goes along with the bipolarness of his character. I don't like you. I find you interesting. You're ugly. You're kinda cute. I'll give you a car and let you touch me. I hate you, and I'm gonna cheat on you with my ex-girlfriend. I love you. I'm gonna make your life miserable and make sure you can never leave this palace. That last bit was a direct quote from Shin himself. Oh yeah, he is that big of a jerk. But once again, because this is from the same writers of Playful Kiss, you have to look more in depth to the facial expressions given from the jerk-faced character towards the main lead to see if there are any inclinations of affection. Which kind of is frustrating because you say to yourself, ooh, wait, his eyes got bigger when he saw her looking pretty that one time in the split second that he went, oh. But other than that, you really don't have the inclination, so you think maybe he really does hate her. It's rather confusing, but at the same time, ingenious. Another problem I had with this jerk-faced character is how he would solve his problems. If something didn't go his way, or if he didn't like the situation, if it was uncomfortable, he would blame what happened on Yule.
It was Yule's idea. Yule told me to do it! Yule gave it to me. Yeah, totally work. Yeah, she'll buy that.
I give Yule the rating of, if you weren't such a mama's boy, you wouldn't have been so pathetic. Honestly, I loved Yule when he wasn't being influenced by his mom. He would have been a wonderful crown prince, a great king, and a sweet and caring husband. But because of his attachment to his mother and listening to everything that she told him to do, he became kind of slimy in my eyes later on in the drama. In fact, I felt like his obsession with trying to take the crown back actually came from his mother himself, that he wouldn't have cared about it very much if she hadn't poisoned his mind into believing that he needed to have the crown back. He was 5 when he left. He doesn't remember being told that he's going to be king someday. It didn't matter to him. Which actually leads me to my next point about Hyorin and Yule. They both were so focused in on what they could have had. Every scene that they showed them by themselves, it was a scene where they're like, ugh! I should have had that. Oh, I should have been that person in that dress. That should be me next to that woman. That should have been me next to that man. So every time that would happen, this song would play in my head.
If any objections to this wedding, speak now or forever. Forever hold your peace. And I stood up and said it should have been me.
Would have dated Yule. I wanted to shrink him down into a little miniature figure and stick him in my pocket for a rainy day because he would have made me happy, I'm sure, because he was just a ball of sunshine through the entire series, except, you know, when he was evil plotting and stuff. I would say this drama is worth it to some degree. But if you can't take a lot of crying and fighting and misunderstandings from married teenagers, then definitely this drama is not for you. To be honest, the first time I watched this drama, I absolutely hated it. However, this was the one drama that kept me up until 6 a.m. on a school night because I had to find out what happened between the characters. I needed to know. I could not stop watching. I needed to know. That is the only time in all of my drama watching where I felt like I had to know what happened to these characters. That it was like life and death for me. I didn't even do that with You're Beautiful. And again, when I rewatched some of the episodes to kind of refresh my memory on what happened in the beginning, I watched 6 episodes without even realizing it. It was 2 a.m. and I was like, what just happened to my life? The best way I can describe the way that this drama is metaphorically is like you're being poisoned by degrees, but the glass that has the poison in it has the face of Hong Ki on it, and it's given to you by Genie himself as he wraps crayon in the background. So your natural reaction is gonna be, yeah, death! Keep them coming, Genie! It's killing me, but I love it! It's just an all-around, well-written story, even though it's not very happy. I just transported 2 days into the future! Yeah, camera problems. They're kind of killing us right now. I promise we're getting a new camera and it will be here for the next review. So just bear with us while we struggle really, really, really badly in this review. Okay, so let's finish up, shall we? Where was I? Oh yeah, it's a well-written story and I absolutely love the mix of the traditional with the modern, especially with the clothing in this drama. But most of all, this drama had the best cuddle scenes I have ever seen in any drama ever. Except for the first night together scene, that was just awkward. But for the rest of it, if anything, watching the cuddle scenes made up for all the fighting and all the stress from the other scenes. It totally made it worth it in the end, just for those few moments of absolute adorableness. Now there is only one small beef left that I have with this drama, and it's actually a major point. The whole story was based around how Shin had to become king, that he needed to get married first and then he was going to become king. He didn't have a choice, that's the way it was going to be, and that's why Yul threatening his position was such a big deal. But when Shin couldn't become king anymore, they just made his obedient older sister become queen. That was an option from the beginning? Do you know how much stress and drama you could have saved yourself if you just made her queen in the first place? I remember saying it when I first saw her that she was the best choice to rule, but I thought to myself, oh no, that can't happen. He has to become king, that's just the way it is. You saying to me that I was right and you guys should have just listened to me in the beginning? You idiots. But it doesn't end there. Shin can't become king. They kind of have a strained relationship and they're distanced from each other. So we have this whole stress at the end thinking, oh my gosh, they're not going to stay together. And I was so livid at this point. I had stayed up until 6 a.m. hoping that they would stay together. And I just was livid thinking that they weren't going to stay together. And then they kind of just conveniently end it where they sort of get married and now we assume they're pregnant. I don't consider that a good ending. In my opinion, now this is just my opinion, I think that they should have become king and queen. Show them loving each other as king and queen and how much they have grown and matured. I felt like that would have been a good ending, seeing them finally being king and queen after all that fighting, after all that pressure, that actually worked out and it was worth it in the end. I felt like all of that stress that I had gone through for their relationship was worthless. I felt like all the fighting that they had had between each other because they were going to become king and queen wasn't validated in the end. That disappointed me a lot. But other than that, you know, it was an okay drama. Give it a whirl. Thank you for allowing me to make your weekend even more dramatic than it already was. If you'd like to see me react to one of your favorite dramas, go to our website, namaste2hkm.blogspot.com. Click on Mindy the Prima Donna, and there's a voting list off to the right where you can vote for the next drama I will review. Once again, that review will be with a brand new